If you're using a spreadsheet and Apple Numbers, you may want to just add a column of numbers like these right here on the screen. We're going to go through the real quick and easy way to do this and the more advanced way in case you're moving data around. This second method will be more flexible. All right, so the first way to do this, as promised, the easiest way, we're going to type an equal sign. So that always lets the spreadsheet know that you're going to enter a formula, not just a number or text, but you're actually going to give a set of instructions. And to do the sum, all you need to do is highlight where the data is. And you'll see this formula that got built for you. So all I've hit on the keyboard is the equal sign. I haven't typed anything else, but it knows the function to use, which is sum, and the range, which is B2 through B5. So at this point, you can hit your enter key and you're done, right? So the sum of these numbers is 20. And if you have other columns to the right, a little shortcut that you can do is hover over the right side of this green rectangle where you see the little yellow dot. Hold down your mouse, go to the right, or your finger on your trackpad, let go, and it copies the formula to the right. So these are live formulas, and let's prove that out by taking, let's say, these four oranges, and we're going to change the 4 to 14 and watch the sum. It updates, right? Because it recalculates whenever this data gets changed. So as promised, that was a simple method. Now I'll show you the bit more advanced way to do it. And what this advanced method will do is if you add lots of different rows down here, we'll even say cart 7, and it will have 10 apples, 20 oranges, and 30 bananas. And as you can see, this row of sums is not picking it up. You didn't tell it to, but it's not smart enough. But let's do it a way that it is. So we will hit delete to get rid of those. And we will go down to the bottom of this table, and you'll notice the bottom row looks a little bit different. It doesn't have highlighting on the first column. And that's because I went over to the format option. I chose table and added a footer. So that's over to the right. You can see in the icon, that's the last row. Yours is probably set at 0. We'll look 0. It looks normal. Change it to a 1, and that gives some superpowers to that last row. And what we can do first, let's just clean this up a little bit. Let's delete some of these empty rows. Delete selected rows, and we'll delete these two. You don't have to, but this is just easier to show it this way. And now that you're working in the footer row, let's do this formula a little bit differently. So we will type equals. And then SUM, that is the name of the function. And now you do an opening parentheses. That's telling the function I'm done typing the name of the function. That's the whole name. And now I'm going to give the inputs. So that's what the beginning parentheses does. And now here's the important part is that instead of typing B2 colon B6, we're going to type the name of the header. So when we set the table properties to have one footer, there was also one header. Because of that, you can use this label. So we can just type apples. We'll close this parentheses off. And you see how this is all highlighted? We'll click on the green check mark. You can also just hit enter. And that's the summation. You can do the same trick to copy it over. And now what you will get is if you add more rows, these formulas that you put in the footer will always be at the bottom and they'll always capture the entire column. All right, so next we're going to talk about how to use pivot tables in Apple Numbers, because once you get your tables up to a certain size, you're going to want to summarize them to figure out what's in them. We're going to learn how to do that in this next video. Thanks for watching.